you grow?
2 weeks and it's not even a sprout.
What did we do wrong?
Sounds like somebody's frustrated.
What are you guys doing?
Well, there's this fair coming up and we want to grow some plants to enter, but they're not growing.
Why would you want to do that anyways?
Well, if they're good enough, you can sell them at the fair.
What? You can get cash for these dumb plants?
It's not just about the money. It's about giving life to something and watching it grow.
Good morning, class.
Good morning, Miss Frizzle.
Well, what do we have here?
Well, we were trying to grow some plants.
Well, luckily, I know someone who can help. And luckily, she's right on time. Good morning, class. I'd like to introduce you to my sister, Miss Drizzle.
Hello, Miss Drizzle.
Hi, Miss Drizzle.
Today, each and every one of you will do something to enter into the fair.
Why? I knew I should have stayed home today.
Does no one understand the importance of plant life or agriculture?
Without plants, our world would cease to exist. That's true, because of the process we know as photosynthesis. The plants take in our carbon dioxide, and as they produce their own food, they release oxygen that our bodies need to survive.
Since I've already grown a garden, do I have to do this?
You've grown a garden? How?
Well, why don't we take a trip to Carlos's house?
To the bus, everyone!
Cruising on down Main Street, you're relaxed and feeling good. Next thing that you know, you'll see it.
From the magic school bus,
alligator nostril.
Climb on the magic school bus.
Back inside, it's a wild ride. Come on!
Ride on the magic school bus.
If you're trying to spruce up your house but don't have enough money for big decorations, well, I got the solution for you guys and gals at home. It involves some seeds and a shovel. Let's get started. When starting your garden, you're going to need good, rich soil. If you grow your plants in bad soil, then they won't have enough nutrients to help them grow big and strong, such as iron and phosphorus. The fun part is picking out your seeds. Whether you're trying to grow a vegetable or a flower, there's so many things to choose from, and that's something I can dig. Water those plants to keep them happy and healthy.
Now for that extra boost, add some fertilizer in with the dirt and mix it around.
Now all you have to do is leave them alone and make sure to check on them periodically. It takes a while for your seedlings to sprout and grow, so don't be discouraged if it doesn't happen right away. Reporting for Ignition TV, I'm Carlos.
I'm starting to rethink this whole growing around plant thing. It's beginning to be too much work. There's gotta be an easier way.
There is. I mean, with all the technology we have now, everything's so much easier.
Well, why don't you show us then, Phoebe?
Hey, Red Devils, Phoebe here. And did you know technology is such a huge part of agriculture? And with Kathleen being the number one in the nation for forestry, they have so much to offer. And I'm here to show you what we've got.
On a regular day in drone class, we come down here in the gym and fly them around to get some practice.
Drones can help detect diseases and insects above groves and on plants. They can also go above fields.
We sweep the barn, weigh pigs.
Technology benefits us because it helps us be more efficient and more accurate.
We learn how to farm and cultivate fish, which is harder than it sounds.
There's a variety of different things that we do in aquaculture. One of the main things is every couple weeks we'll learn a different variety of ornamental fish.
You don't want to have a 5 gallon tank for 100 pound fish, so you try and do tank to fish ratio, how much water you want per fish, how healthy the water is.
And remember, if it weren't for such technologies, we wouldn't have the agriculture advances that we have today. For Ignition TV, I'm Phoebe, signing off.
Okay, so growing plants is an option, but what about those of us who don't want to do that? Is there anything else we could do for the fair?
Well, there are many people with your very same dilemma. Instead, they show other things, such as animals.
Wow, you can show animals? I have no idea how to get them prepared for the fair, but I love the idea anyway.
Well, Miss Frizzle said that there were other people involved. Why don't you go and ask them what they're doing to prepare?
Hey there, Kathleen. Arnold here. When you hear the word fair, what do you think of? You probably think of carnival food or rides or throw up everywhere. Well, when the agriculture department hears the word fair, they think of dedication, determination, discipline, hard work, time and effort. Because they, of course, think of the Polk County Youth Fair. You may be asking what the Youth Fair is. Well, I'm here to tell you. I asked some of the teachers and students what it is they do at the youth fair.
Students raise market, which is steers and hogs, which means they get them when they're young, they raise them out to a slaughter weight or a desirable market weight, and they sell them. And then some students raise rabbits and chickens and show those, and then we also have students who do plants.
I do a lot of things in the youth fair. I show steers, heifers, horses. I did pigs in the past. I've done chickens, rabbits. I even have competed in the chili cook-off that they always have.
Students who enter the Polk County Youth Fair benefit in a lot of ways. The first thing they do is they learn responsibility. They are caring for living things. They have to feed them, take care of all their health, and that includes holidays, Christmas break.
I've been involved in the youth fair since I was in sixth grade, so this year it'll be my fourth year.
And then they also just learn good general skills when it comes to writing letters, because they have to approach different buyers to try to get them to purchase their products.
The most beneficial is probably just the experience and learning how to do it this now, so that when I do get older, I'll know how.
Well, this has been Arnold reporting for Ignition TV. See you later, Kathleen.
The Trident Yearbook crew will be selling candy cane grams for $1 in the lunchroom December 10th, 11th, 14th, and 15th. These will go to a person of your choice along with a personalized message and be delivered the morning of December 18th. KHS is offering free ACT tutoring on Tuesdays and Thursdays in Ms. Gardner's room in Q-Wing. If you'd like to get a free ACT waiver, then just simply attend the sessions. Also, the district is handing out free bus rides to and from testing sites, and if you'd like to know more about that, just go to the main office. FCA will be having its 2015 neighborhood cleanup on Saturday, December 12th. If you'd like to participate in this event, simply show up at 7:45 in the morning in the Choice Room. The cleanup will be held from 8 to 12. See Coach Troutman for more information.
There's still a problem. Our plants won't grow.
Hey Frizz, there isn't anything you can do to help these girls out?
Well, maybe I can try a little of this.
How did you do that?
Oh, you know. Just yourself and life back on the magic school.